Hola, bienvenido a mi canal. Espero que les vaya bien. Now, you might be wondering, why am I just talking in Spanish right now? Well, hope you've seen by the title. Today, I'm going to be doing a how to study a language video. So, vamos! I think every person has heard of Duolingo. It's a really good language app, to be honest. I personally do use it a lot. I use it to like study because, well, it's just really interactive and it keeps you motivated. Plus, there's a strike, so I really, really, really want to get like a year strike so that I can just like show off to my friends, and it's just, you feel really accomplished after that. Duolingo, I think, contains a few sections. They have the like normal lessons where you just learn the new words and new phrases. You also have the story time, but I think you have to like get like 5 or is it 10 crowns to like be able to unlock them. And you also have the listening and like sort of speaking interactive lessons. And now I think that they have the tutoring thing. Personally, I don't use the Duolingo tutoring thing because, well, I use another app for that, but I'll tell you guys later about it. I find that using Duolingo, it gets me to memorize the like new words a lot better because, you know, it just feels fun. There's like this, there are like a few characters who would like wave to you and do all those fun things, and it's just really interactive, and I feel like I'm an interactive person because I learn things better when they're like taught to me. Like I can't self-learn, but I just need someone to help me. Now, how to take the notes. Well, as you can see here, I used to use 2 different pens. The purple was for the Spanish or the other language, and I use black for English. Now, I just use pure black because I just like, I didn't want to change my pen like over and over again. It was just really frustrating and it really like demotivates me. So try keeping it simple. Apart from Spanish, I also learn French. So yeah, just started learning French like I think 1 month ago, so I'm still not quite too sure about like speaking. I mean I can't say bonjour, but no, just not very confident right now to say it. Listening, reading, writing, and I think speaking, those are the four main elements to any language. Personally, I don't have any trouble with reading and writing because, well, I see them every day, but I am now practicing my speaking and listening skills. Speaking, I think I can do like better than I did before. It just like sounds more fluent. Like, sort of, you know. But a major problem with me is that I can't, like, listen. Listening is one of the hardest things, I feel like, when you're, like, when I listen to, like, something, my mind just goes blank. Like, I'm trying to figure out what the word is, but I just can't figure it out. It's so frustrating. So getting a tutor really just helps you with all of that. And, yeah. Now, after when you've like had a little practice and like know a few phrases and a few like, probably you just need to know the present tense, and then I highly recommend you get a tutor because like they would like have a conversation with you and it just really like practices your speaking skills. I remember when I first had my lesson with my tutor, it was like terrible because I just couldn't like, I know how to express it, but when I like say it out loud it just sounded really weird. But we're getting to there. I've been studying with my tutor for like at least I think 4 months and I really do see the progress. Now you can use any like app, obviously. Just highly recommend you get a tutor. Yeah. Next, moving on to the reading. Reading. It really helps you to like learn a lot of new phrases. As you can see right now, I'm reading Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. It's one of my favorite books. I love it. I just love the like the magical. I love the chocolate water fountain, or let's say just chocolate waterfall. Wow, I just love it. I learned so many new words in that book. I learned, I think, waterfall, casada, I think, yeah. And also, another great tip is try to learn a few like phrases, like more casual phrases, like idiomas, like sort of like that. Those like help you like feel like or sound more native. For example, we say a bookworm, but in Spanish they don't say that. They say un ratón de biblioteca, which translates to the rat of the library. Yeah, it sounds very like, wow. I'm very shocked by all of those different cultures and how they would express the phrase. For a more academic purpose, since I picked Spanish for my GCSEs, I would also need to learn like all of the like different topics and the words I need to know. So I go on BBC Bite Size, I go on that to like learn. It's just really helpful. They have the translation, the listening, which by the way I'm terrible at, but you're getting improvement every time you do it. So really it's a great thing to do. They also have a little test at the very back where you can like test yourself to see if you've like grasped everything. And if you haven't, that's okay. That just means you're improving more and more each time. A lot of the people who like don't want to learn language is also because of the vocabulary. And I get you, like the adjectives, all of those stuff, those are hard to memorize. But obviously you have to memorize them because you can't say a language like naturally with just those limited few words that you have. So a thing that I do is I use Quizlet. I know it's not the most ideal way to learn a language, but I mean, yeah. I go on Quizlet and make flashcards like of the words. Like I write the English or the Spanish in front and then flip it and I write the Spanish or English, yeah. And I just like test them like yeah, like regularly, like practice makes perfect. So you need to practice regularly and you'll grasp the all of the new words, trust me. Now you're probably watching this and like, what? Peppa Pig, I'm too old for that. But it's never like out of date to learn a language. I remember when I was small, I used to learn English and I used to watch Peppa Pig all the time. And that's how I can like talk to you now. It just like started me up in my English language learning. So yeah, you're never too old to watch Peppa Pig, let me tell you. They talk in such like a casual and not textbook way, and you'll be able to learn a lot of new words and phrases just by watching it. It's super, super, super cool. And it's actually quite fun. I mean, they keep releasing new episodes and it's really fun to watch. So, after that, I hope you might want to start learning a new language for yourself. So, thank you for watching. Gracias and adios. Bye.